But here's a question. I mean, did you ever, when you're, I mean, you just described not an easy life. It's not like I just show up and be beautiful and win a pageant. You put a lot of hard work into that. And I mean, at any point, did you feel like you were objectified, or did you feel like you were any less of a woman?
Absolutely not. Let me tell you, so there's more queens behind stage than those that are wearing tiaras, if you know what I mean.
Okay.
The real queens are the men that run these pageants. But I had a blast. I never once felt objectified, exploited. If anything, I felt celebrated for my talent and my hard work. Exactly. And remember, this is a volunteer thing. You don't have to do this.
Mm-hmm.
You really don't. And honestly, by the time you factor in the training, the coaching, the gowns, all that goes into it, whatever scholarship you get really offsets those initial expenses. So unless you're winning the big thing, you really make your money on the appearances. That's where it really happens. And then you can rack that up. But in terms of scholarship, what they'll do is they'll provide scholarships to the school that you're going to. Mm. So it's not like they're giving you a
check and you
can do what you want with it.
Oh, man.
What they'll do is what they did, at least when I was in it, they made the check out right to the school that I was in. That way there was no funny money in between.
All that work. So now, what would you change this, or would you leave it alone? What would you do?
I think it needs to die. Honest to God, I think Miss America just needs to I don't want her to be like that. You remember that show Cats? There's the glamour cat that sings Memory. I don't want Miss America to be some old trollop. Memory! Some old thing in a rhinestone schmata.
Let it go.
I honestly think it was a good fight. It was valiant. There's other ways for women to be... I mean, what happens if you're an architect or a chemical engineer? But because you can't come up with a two-minute talent, you're pretty much out of the pageant.
Oh.
There are many brilliant, and I dare say this, Steve, brilliant, intelligent, involved women. Sometimes you win by not winning. And I remember years ago, I was judging a pageant,
mm-hmm.
and there was this contestant there, and she was an incredible dancer. She danced with the Alvin Ailey Dance Company, and she was flawless.
Right.
Flawless. But again, as I said, the way to win this thing is to be consistent across all competitions. So her dance blew everybody out of the water. Her evening gown, her interview, not so much. And she was first runner-up. And let me tell you, Steve, she was crestfallen.
Oh.
Crestfallen because she didn't win. I took her aside. I said, listen, you'll win more by not winning. Because now you can live your life and do what you want, take your first runner-up scholarship money and run with it. You don't have to wear a banner and a tiara all year long to do a ribbon cutting or speak to a charity group.
That is great.
You can live your life and take the money. So honestly, I think you can win more
by not winning. Right?
You can. Is not too shabby either. It's fine.
Ruth, man, thanks for coming on. It's been a long time.
My joy, Steve. It's great to talk to you again. Thanks again.
Same here. Okay.